Good morning, viewers. Thank you for joining me today for this quick review of this clever mesh bracelet that I've purchased, aftermarket mesh bracelet that I've purchased to fit to this Remaster 300 meter tuna diver's watch. So this bracelet, I bought this from a brand called Strapcode. The strap was originally shipped from Hong Kong. And if you were to find their website, it would be listed as a 22 millimeter tapered shark mesh band stainless steel watch bracelet, comma V clasp, comma polished. And I picked the size BC, which refers to a 138 to 152 millimeter in diameter wrist. So let me just kind of describe what this bracelet is, and then I can tell you kind of why I bought it. So this is a Milanese mesh. I believe it's originally called Milanese mesh. It's basically stainless steel wire that's been looped into a loom and threaded together to make like this flexible kind of chainmail mesh bracelet. And originally these were manufactured long time ago in Switzerland and in Germany for the original Omega Ploprof diver's watch. And the Ploprof was a saturation suitable diver's watch manufactured by Omega, I think partially in conjunction with a partnership with some inspiration and guidance from Jacques Cousteau and the Comex French underwater excavation company or engineering company. Basically, this is a reproduction or a true recreation of that style of strap. Those straps were popular in the late 1960s and 1970s with some really, sort of purpose-built Omega dive watches. And if, those straps originally came on a seatbelt clasp. This is an actual Omega Ploprof buckle. These are seatbelt type buckles. And what happened is you'd strap the watch on and press it and it would lock into place just like a seatbelt. This clasp, this bracelet and clasp, this is actually a different clasp. I'll talk to you about that in a moment. This bracelet cost me $112. That included, and then $15 shipping, and that it made it from Hong Kong to the East Coast of the United States in 3 days. Shipping was exquisitely fast, and I was really, really pleased. And I've generally been pleased by the strap. This strap has been recommended to me by a number of other watch enthusiasts. And while a long time ago, I had an original Omega mesh strap, which is why I have this buckle still. I haven't had one in over a decade, maybe 15 years since I had a mesh strap. And I'll say that while I don't think the quality is quite as good as the original mesh that I had, or the newer mesh that comes on the newer Omega Ploprofs, those watches are significantly more expensive. And for the money, this is a very, very good value in my opinion. And it feels like it would last a lifetime of use and could take a beating and would still look good. So this bracelet, one thing you have to keep in mind, and the Strapcode website emphasizes this on the purchase page, is that these straps cannot be sized. So, this segment right here is one size. And other than the adjustability of the clasp, and it came with a clasp that looks like this, and I'll talk about that in a sec. Other than that adjustability, you're stuck. So you can't, I have seen examples of where people will take wire snips and just cut through these and one row of links is probably 3 millimeters, and maybe you could save 3 millimeters, but in truth, you're better off just buying the right size. So measure your wrist before you buy. Let me emphasize that this video is neither sponsored nor endorsed or referenced by the brand. I have no relationship to them other than being a customer. It's the only bracelet I've ever purchased from them, the only business I've ever dealt with them. But I've been pleased and I wanted to share this. So, after, scrolling through Instagram and social media, I've seen this kind of mesh bracelet on a lot of divers watches lately. I thought, why not give it a shot? So I bought this bracelet and I've been pleased. What I was not pleased with really was the clasp. And now a lot of people really love these clasps and would consider them to be a very high quality. The clasp doesn't have a micro adjust like a on the fly micro adjust. This clasp has, you know, it's a push button release with a clamshell cover. You know, it's a nice clasp. A lot of people tout that it's a heavier gauge metal and it feels very sturdy, and that's true, it does. Has this thick plate right here, these nicely drilled holes. The holes are countersunk on the inside. If you were to look right here, those holes are countersunk. You should be able to see that on both sides. It does feel like a very nice, nicely executed clasp. However, to size it, you have to take off the bracelet and move the little spring pin. So instead, what I did is I attached it to this Marine Master clasp. This is a clasp that comes with the stock bracelet for this watch, which, as you all know, looks like this. And the advantage of that for me is that I can adjust it on the fly. Also, you know, for anyone considering buying this bracelet, this mesh bracelet, know that the end links, the end pieces will fit perfectly on a traditional Marine Master clasp. And those are the original spring bars for the Marine Master clasp on both sides. And they fit in just fine. There's no wedging or forcing needed. They fit just fine. And that's a nice touch if you sort of really enjoy the Marine Master clasp and you want to use it on this bracelet. So that's what I did. The spring bars, however, that came with this watch are of a very, very thin size. They look like this. Just not suitable for a Marine Master, in my opinion, because the spring bars right here have a much thicker tip. Let's see. See, there's a difference in the tip diameter by quite a bit. So, unfortunately, these larger spring bars do not fit through the orifice or the holes in the mesh right here. So I ended up using essentially a 1.8 millimeter spring bar instead of a 2.5 millimeter spring bar. I believe the original Seiko spring bars are 2.8 or 2.5. I bought some thick spring bars that are drilled, that are flangeless, shoulderless, that have some confidence in, and I use those, and they're probably 1.78 to 1.85 millimeters in diameter. I don't think I have a spare one to show you, but I've been pleased. You know, they articulate really well. There's a little bit of magic marker on it, so just ignore that. The bracelet fits loose enough to where you don't feel like it's gonna pop. It's you know, being forced against the case or anything, but snug enough to where you feel like it's a good hold. So, yeah, so you can see that. I believe I originally got these spring bars from like Toxic Natos or somewhere like that, but I don't think they're still in business. You just have to hunt around. So I think probably the only thing this video adds to the conversation, if you will, is the fact that, I mean, in my opinion, I think, unless it's already been said before, these 22 millimeter mesh bracelets from Strapcode can be used with an authentic Marine Master clasp, you know, adjustable clasp. The same clasps appear on like some Grand Seikos, the Grand Seiko divers, so it would work with those as well. Though I've not tried it on the Grand Seiko. And I also would say that these bracelets are of a sufficient quality to warrant the price tag. I think $100 is a lot of money for a bracelet, but I think I got what I paid for, especially if you consider the shipping costs that, you know, got here so quickly. One thing I'll note is that the bracelet has, it progressively becomes more flexible as you move from the clasp end to the case, the case attachment point. What I mean by that is, the best way to describe it is to say, like, you can see they will sort of flex this way and that. You hear that? Sort of torsional sound. But then if you look right here, right there, that arch, that's the extent of its flexibility right there. And that's because these links are very close together. But as you move outward towards the watch case, you'll notice that the radius of the bend becomes narrower and narrower and narrower, to where right beside the case, they fold basically over themselves, whereas you can't fold them that way at the case. So I think this is perfectly suitable because where a bracelet really needs to be especially flexible, in my opinion, is up by the wrist. That way it can fold around a narrow wrist or fold or kind of move around, in my opinion. Also, both sides, but the noon side and the 6 p.m. side, 6 o'clock side, have essentially the exact same level of articulation as it extends out down towards the clasp. So, but I think it fits, and, you know, it works very well. I think it's because as you move from the clasp to the head of the watch, they sort of, the way this strap tapers is they just sort of pull the mesh apart and spread it out, or they compress it as it gets closer to the clasp. I'm not quite sure how it's manufactured, but I think the taper is quite consistent. Although the bracelet does sort of want to kind of fold one way, kind of twist one way, but I think as it kind of, I wear it and it kind of gets some body oils in it, it'll soften up even more. And then, but yeah, so like if you look at it, that's probably a good example. Like there's really a consistent taper, and I think they've done quite a good job. I'll say that one thing is that, you know, if you look along the side here closely, you'll see where they clipped the mesh. You can see there's a clip there, clip there, clip there. And then what they've done is they've sort of like polished it and tried to like maybe burnish the ends. But if you're really trying to, you can get your finger kind of on the tips, and it can kind of be a little sharp. So you know, like, I think they've done a really good job trying to remove the sharp points, but there are some sharp points. And I noticed that, like, if you're wearing like a thick wool sweater or something, these little what I'm saying is, like, basically the wires. Not focusing. If you can see that part. And that part, basically where the wire has ended its spiral and has been snipped or cut and then polished down, they do have the ability to kind of catch fabric. I think for the most part, they're fine, but just know that. So would I recommend this? I would recommend this to someone who thinks they might want to try a mesh bracelet. You know, I think a mesh bracelet is not for every day. I think a mesh bracelet is for some days. And I think for me, I will probably wear it a few weeks on, a few weeks off, maybe during the summertime. But it's an interesting change up. And if you have a few watches and you like to change the bracelets, this is a really nice option to consider. Again, you know, I think the best way to wear this is probably on something that's toolish, like more of a tool watch. I think some people might see the design aesthetics as being sort of dressy because it's polished. I think the brand offers a brushed version, but I wanted the one that looked more like the original. But I think it connotes, or it sort of suggests more of a toolish look. And I think that wearing it on an actual Marine Master clasp makes it look more, I don't know, original in a way. I think this clasp that comes with it is totally acceptable, but I prefer not to. So yeah, that's my quick review of this Strapcode mesh bracelet. Again, this is the 22 millimeter tapered shark mesh band, stainless steel watch bracelet, V clasp, polished. And the size for my 7.5 inch wrist is the BC size, which is denoted by 138 to 152 millimeters. And I think the way they come up with that is they attach the segments to the original clasp, and then they measure the length from one end, one spring bar end to the other, based on between the smallest hole and the most extended hole. So I'm not quite convinced that that's quite true, but I think the measurements give enough flexibility so that if you're thoughtful with picking the right size, you won't be disappointed with the sizing of it at least. Okay, please like and subscribe. Please know that I normally try to post videos on Fridays. For my long-term followers, I'm sorry I haven't posted any videos lately. I'm gonna try and create more content and get some videos ready so that I can update my channel. Thanks so much for following. Please like and subscribe and be well.